Okay, this video is on whether or not you should go to the store and buy your Pompano surf rigs, or you should make your own. Well, I'll bet you there's a lot of people out there that are hesitant to make their own rigs because they just don't know how much it's going to cost. They don't know how much they're going to save, and it's just so much easier to get on the internet and buy a few rigs and you're good to go. But if you're really going to be a surf fisherman and spend a lot of time out there, you're going to have to determine this, because trust me, when Mr. Shark comes along and sharks you off, and when I say you get sharked off, that means you've got three poles or more up and you notice that one of them bounces heavily and then it goes slack and then the other two do the same thing. Well, you just got sharked off. You just lost your rig, you lost a certain amount of mono, you lost your sinker, and I can tell you it will happen if you're out there long enough. I had one day on the beach where I got sharked off approximately 10 times in an hour, and you say, well, heck, why would you stay? Well, sometimes you have to learn to play with the sharks because they're out there to get Mr. Pompano, so sometimes you have to wait them out for a bit, but unfortunately, and when they're in there thick, they can cost you a lot. So I created this video to let you know, well, what's it going to cost for me? You know, here's a video of my dad on my site tying one of his rigs here. And, he was in his 80s and he made this little jig here. And I've got videos on that too. And it was just so simple. And more than that, not only was he saving money, and I'll show you exactly how much in a few minutes, but he really had fun doing it too. You know, he was making his own rigs. He could make his own colors. You know, he didn't have to worry about what was in the store because he was in, total control of the whole process. So, let's go ahead and let's take a look at what it costs you to make these rigs. Now, I'm not going to go over every line item here, but these are pretty accurate prices. Now, as the video gets older, it's going to change, but the first thing you got to do is go out and get yourself some 50-pound tests. Now, most of the rigs out there are made with 20-pound, they're made with 25-pound. Well, I can tell you after years of fishing that I have learned from old-timers that when you're using 50-pound for your rigs, they can withstand that school of bluefish before you go to catch a pompano. If you got 20-pound or 25-pound and it gets a slight nick and then you're trying to haul in that 3-pound, 4-pound pompano, there's a chance it's going to break that line. And I'm a firm believer in mono. You can believe what you want, but there are studies that have been done, and fluorocarbon, they say, well, it's invisible, and well, that's great, and it has an abrasion resistance that's horrible. So research it yourself, and not only that, I don't think the color is that huge of a deal. I knew an old-timer that made rigs that had dark green line, and he caught fish by the bucket, because he was using the right bait and he knew how to read the beach and he was making his own rig. So anyways, you're going to have to buy this 50-pound test anyways because you're going to need shock leader. I've got a video on line specifications and I tell you about the importance of a shock leader, but you're going to have to buy the shock leader anyways. So, and I like going with 1-pound spools. They're a lot less, they have a lot less kink because it's a bigger spool. And what I've done here is I have taken the cost of each item, okay? And then I determined how many pompano rigs I would get out of a spool. Here's just a case of the 50-pound test. Now, you don't have to use it all for your rigs. Use some of it for, for your shock leader. But if it's 50-pound and you got 1,270 yards, well, that's 3,810 feet. Well, if you take that mono and you divide it by 3 feet, that's approximately what you're going to use for a two-hook pompano rig. Well, you're going to get 1,270 pompano rigs. Now, that doesn't mean you have to make that many. You know, your shock leaders should be about 25, 30 foot long, but that's the cost. You know, it's 2.3 cents per rig for this particular line. And keep in mind, this suffix tritanium I'm talking about, it's a hybrid. You know, it's not just mono. It's a hybrid line, or I don't know the exact science of it, but it's got some fluoro in there, and it's good stuff. And anyways, and I go through on each one. I tell you where to buy this stuff, and then I tell you what the cost is, and then we got the math down here. And, you know, and pause this video if you want to read these a little longer. And then I go down here and I do the math on everything. You know, the dual lock snaps come in a 100 count bag, so that's 6.9 cents per rig. And basically what it comes down to, when you after you get your hooks, you know, and keep in mind too, while we're talking about hooks, a lot of these rigs don't have very good hooks on them too. I can find a flaw in almost every store-bought rig out there. The only way you're going to get the rig you want is to build it yourself. And here we go, 81.5 cents per rig to build an excellent rig. And you're doing it yourself. You're enjoying it. And, you know, go co-op. If you got a couple other fishing buddies and you want to share the cost, well, you know, you could split it with one or two guys. But anyways, and these decent pompano rigs, you know, are at least $3 per rig if they're decent. And, you know, and while we're talking about making your own stuff, well, you should make your own sinkers too. You know, the cheapest you're going to find sinkers are a little over $1 a sinker from eBay. And that's on a 4 ounce. You're going to pay more for a 5 ounce. And, I mean, I make hundreds of sinkers. It's kind of hard to amortize the cost, but you know, it's cheap. This 20 cents is probably too high. I go out, I'm resourceful, I get my own lead for free, and there are 100 videos on YouTube on how to get your own free lead, and I'll leave you up to that. But so anyways, getting back to our costs here, if you make your own, if you don't make your own sinker in your own rig, every time you get sharked off, you're losing $4. And, you know, what's going to happen is, well, if you're the average Joe fisherman out there and you're buying rigs, you're going to get sharked off 3 times. You're going to get disgusted. You're going to leave the beach and you're going to leave the pompano behind too. You know, when you get sharked off with your own gear, including a sinker, it's about $1. And that's huge. That is huge. A $3 difference. You know, if you go to Amazon, you know, you can get good deals on this suffix in a 50 pound. And I've mentioned these guys before, but these are Chaos Fishing. You know, I know sometimes you go right to chaosfishing.com. They have certain sales and you may not want to use suffix. You may want to use your own brand. But keep in mind, too, when we're talking about those hooks earlier, you know, this to me is my go-to hook. This is the Eagle Claw L197 2-aught hook, and here's a good price here, Amazon 100-pack for $24.87. And if you pay close attention, I don't know how well you understand hooks, but there are a lot of rigs out there that don't have a circle hook, or they might call it a circle hook, but it's not. It's a Kale hook. And you say, well, geez, what's the difference? You know, they look pretty close. Well, they aren't that close. What's going to happen is this circle hook is a wonderful hook. You never have to set the hook when you get a bite. Just start reeling in. That's it. Now, these Kale hooks, they're almost the same principle, but what you're going to find is the fish is going to swallow it heavier. And if you are trying to catch and release a fish because it's not something you want to keep, there's a good chance that fish may not make it. So if you care about the environment, I would stay away from the Kale hooks on these pompano rigs. And earlier we talked about how to find your own lead. Well, there you go. There's a ton of videos here. And if you go to Amazon, you can also find what I like, this Magnum melter. Don't ever buy a melter that has the little lever so you're dispensing it down below. It's just going to plug up. This Magnum melter is really good. And I talk more about that in my sinker videos. I've got a couple of different sinker videos out there. And that's it. You know, I mean, well, we're going to save a ton. We're going to save $3 a rig if you make your own stuff. And, you know, I always say in my videos, challenge yourself. Do it yourself. You're going to enjoy it. You're going to not only enjoy it, you're going to save money, and you're going to have any type of rig you want. I've also got a nice video on making your own Pompano rig floats for a penny a piece. So that'll do it for this video. I hope you've learned a lot. And if you enjoyed it, please subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to hit that little bell so you can get notifications for new videos. And that'll do it for this video.